NetCeler's automated fault analysis is a technology that is going to take use of the digital data from the field. And the kind of data we are able to process are essentially the disturbance records, either from protection relays or digital fault recorders like this one, but also event logs from substation automation systems or from sequence of event recorders. And eventually, additionally, let's say event-related data like, for example, lightning strikes, some information from the field that something has happened, like also SCADA lists and so on. So all this information first needs to be gathered. It's not that we absolutely want to have centralized solutions, but you have to correlate what happens in different stations if you have to understand the complete sequence of events appropriately. And so the first step is to collect, for example, disturbance records, which is the most important data set from the field. And this can be done by exporting disturbance records in COMTrade format in each substation automation system, or eventually we may communicate directly with the device, like a disturbance recorder in this case. And that may represent a lot of data, actually. But now we have TCP/IP connections to the substations, and it is a fast process. With the last generation of technology, it may take, for example, 1 minute or two to get a disturbance record from a relay up to a server in the data center. The protocols for the communication are more oriented towards control and protection applications than towards monitoring applications. But protocols like the 104 protocol or 61850 support a file transfer service. And this file transfer allows us to collect a COMTrade file, which is the format, the standardized format for disturbance records, from either a data collector or device to a central location. You need to distinguish the communication protocols that are used within the substations, like typically the 103 protocol, which is traditionally used in Europe and in Asia and so on, and the 61850, because nowadays modern substations are built with a redundant high-speed 61850 bus. But this is in the substation. We usually don't touch this, especially for cybersecurity reasons. We leave all this communication within the substation. And then we need a gateway that is going to connect our monitoring world to the substation environment. And if it is not the substation automation system itself, then a dedicated gateway can be used that is going to talk to the device, for example, through 61850, produce the COMTrade file, and we would download the file from the gateway, either through FTP protocol, for example, or 104. Also, bay controller units, BCUs, or remote terminal units, RTUs, may be used as gateways. And we have interesting experience, for example, by using the 104 protocol between the data center and the RTU to get exactly those COMTrade files.